replace the water heater, we're going to replace the thermal expansion tank, and we're going to install a pressure reducing valve on the house because they are on city water, and the pressure during the daytime is around 80 pounds. At nighttime, it's going to increase from there, and that's too much pressure on your house. So we're going to put a pressure reducing valve in, replace the expansion tank, put a new water heater in, and get everything swapped out. This is the water meter, because they have city water here. As I explained before, the pressure in the house is too high. So we're gonna add in what we call a pressure reducing valve here. And that will allow us to basically restrict the pressure coming in. So we can take it, let's say, you know, at nighttime, if it gets up to 110 or 120 PSI, we can take it and it's always gonna come through at whatever we set it at. I believe the one we have will max out at 75 pounds. We'll probably set it to around 70, which is more than enough. Whatever the pressure fluctuates on the other side, it's gonna stay at 70 or wherever we set it on the outgoing side. So we're also gonna add that into here as well. There's nothing wrong with this heater other than the age of it. I was out for a leak one weekend. They had flexible hoses on top. If you see the copper is new up there, they had some flexible hoses that broke and were leaking water all over the place. So I was out over the weekend, swapped that stuff so we can get it back up and running, and then gave them a price to replace this due to the age, replace the tank because the expansion tank above us is bad, and then add in the pressure reducing valve. So they decided to do that. They just wanted to wait about a month or so, and now we're back. Now that I've taken the fitting off, I'm just reheating it so that I can melt the solder again, wipe off the excess solder so that I can fit my new fitting on there. So that's what we're doing. We're just going to heat it up so it's nice and molten, and then just wipe it off. We changed the heaters. It was pretty much the same heater that was here before. I believe there are different brands, but same size. We just went with a shorter heater because of the way the blue pipe was before. It was pitching back towards when it shouldn't be. It should be pitching to the unit. So what we're doing is that changed the height of where the burners are. This nipple was in here before, and I didn't have a straight connection there. It wasn't lining up. It's a threaded fitting, so I can't just cut it and connect to it. I'd have to thread it. I don't have a threader with me. We have one at the shop, but it's easier to just get a pre-made nipple from our supply house down the road. So all we're doing is we're just changing to a 4-foot nipple, and that's gonna allow me to have another connection here where I'll put our new gas valve here, and I can actually adjust the height a little bit easier and make everything line up properly. I tried to adjust it, but it wasn't gonna work that way. So we're just gonna swap it out and make it work like that. Our tank tied in, hot and cold are tied in, gas is all set. I turned on the gas to the house again, purged it out. Purge out meaning I cracked the union. I got the air out of the line and then put it back together. I bubble tested everything. So we're just patching in right now where the old one was. We took out the T. We didn't want to just cap it and then allow stuff to catch there. So we're just gonna run a straight piece of copper through there. We're gonna put on a pressure reducing valve. We're gonna set that up down there, fill it up and get them running.
Is our pressure reducing valve, or PRV. We got the union on one side. We're actually gonna set up with the union on both sides so that can be changed in the future, because over time they do fail.
I also like to set it up. We're gonna do this, 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 and this. We'll set it up like so. We'll put two gauges in here, 0 to 200 pound gauges, one on each side, so I can always see what the incoming pressure is, and then the outgoing pressure as well. The gauges can fail. You can always screw on a secondary gauge that I carry on the truck and test that way, but this allows the homeowner to see what's going on and just makes my life easier too. If I ever have to come back out and work on it, I can see. You'll see when I go to adjust this later, you'll see this gauge climb as we increase the pressure in the house. So we're gonna set this up and put it in. I think we're gonna stay there, right at 70.
Right where you want to be.
Yep. During the day, you're gonna see a lower pressure than you are at night because everyone's using stuff during the day. At night, you're gonna see that pressure climb. This could easily get up to, I don't know exactly what it does here at night, I haven't been here at night, but this could be over 100, 120. I've been in other towns where they've had that situation where it was 125 in the middle of the night. Blew the relief valve on the water heater because the expansion tank went bad. That one can fluctuate back and forth. This restricts that now. It's only gonna be 70 pounds going out. It's got basically a check valve built into it. That's why we need that thermal expansion tank over there now, because now that water pressure can't push back through here. It won't allow it, so. But now you can see on both gauges what the pressure's gonna be at. So we're just gonna lock our retaining nut back down so that it doesn't adjust. And that is pretty much it.
The new heater's in. We relocated the expansion tank, put a new expansion tank in, charged it to where it should be, installed a pressure reducing valve on the house. That's pretty much it. New one's in, old one's out in the truck. We're done.